The files were transferred onto the computer and then shredded. But not this one. This file my husband kept. To bring out now and again and ponder. He was never satisfied, you see. Never. Then one day, he read something in the newspaper about an old woman who died in an accident. She shuddered. I'm not even going to speak about it. There's plenty of information in here. He made copious notes. I'll just talk about what I know. About Trudy's accident, Alex said. Mrs. Harkness ran her hand over the file as if it was a precious object. I can't believe I'm saying this, out in the open after all these years. My husband, John, thought about it often, and when he stopped working, he began to obsess about it. Couldn't let it go. It gave him a lot of sleepless nights. That's why I thought, well, if you ask, I'll tell you. I knew my husband. He wasn't a fanciful man. He was a very practical person, not given to wild imaginings. He thought there was something wrong about Trudy's death. Trudy's death? Oh, yes. He considered it was a malicious accident caused by Edward, but what worried him most was the death of Trudy's mother. He was sure that was deliberate. Murder. Alex felt as though he had been punched in the ribs, and heard Marion's sharp intake of breath. The shadow of evil crept over the room, and he shivered, despite the sunshine. He looked at Mrs. Harkness, saw in her face the relief that comes with confession. It was out in the open. It was said. From now on, it was his burden to bear. I think, Mrs. Harkness, I might ask Marion to make us another pot of tea, if you wouldn't mind. Then, perhaps you could take us through it. Right from the very beginning. Yes, right from the very beginning.